In this segment, we're going to find the determinant of a matrix, and we're going to look at an example. So we're going to find the determinant of an example matrix, and the method which we're going to use to find the determinant of this example matrix is using the Gaussian elimination part, which is the forward elimination part on the matrix, and use that to be able to find the determinant. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take an example like this one. So let's suppose somebody says, hey, go to find the determinant of this matrix, 25, 5, 1, 64, 8, 1, 144, 12, 1. And what we want to do is we want to follow the steps of forward elimination as given for the new Gaussian method and see that how can we find the determinant of this matrix. So basically what we're trying to do is once we convert, once we apply the forward elimination steps on this particular matrix, what's going to happen is that you're going to end up with an upper triangular matrix. You're going to end up with an upper triangular matrix like this one. And once you end up with an upper triangular matrix like this one, then the determinant of this matrix will be same as the determinant of this matrix. But we already know that the determinant of upper triangular matrix is simply the multiple of the diagonal elements, so it makes it very easy to find out what the determinant of this original matrix is. So let's go and conduct these forward elimination steps on this particular matrix here, and then we can see that, hey, what the determinant of this matrix is. So how do I go about doing that? So there will be two steps of forward elimination here. In the first step of forward elimination, what's going to happen is that I'm going to make this element to be 0, and I'm going to make this element to be 0. Because eventually I want to end up with zeros and zeros and 0 right here. So I'm going to do it one at a time. So I'm going to take the first row. So what I'm going to do is take the first row and make use this element to make this to be 0 and this to be 0. So what I have to do is I'll have to divide this first row by 25 and multiply it by 64 and then subtract it so as to make this to be 0. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take 64 divided by 25. That turns out to be equal to 2.56. Because I'll have to divide by 25 and multiply by 64, which means same as multiplying by 2.56. So I'm going to take this 25, 5, and 1, which is my first row. I'm going to multiply it by 2.56. And what do I get by doing that? I get 64, 12.8, and 2.56. And you can very much see that all I'm doing is taking a multiple of the first row, and I get this, and I'm going to subtract it from my second row right here. And what that's going to do is 64 is going to cancel with 64 here. It's going to give me a 0. And that's what I want to eventually do. I want to get a 0 right there so that I can convert this into upper triangular matrix. So let's go and write this down right here. So I have 64, 8, and 1. Which is my row 2. This is my row 2. And what I just got by multiplying first row by 2.56 is 64, 12.8, and 2.56. And I'm going to subtract the two. So I'm going to get 0, minus 4.8, and minus 1.56. This is what's going to happen to the second row after I subtract it. So this is going to be my new row 2. Now let's go and see what we have to do for row 3. In row 3, I'll have to divide by 25 and multiply by 144 because I have 144 in my third row first column. So I'll have to divide by 25, multiply by 144, and that turns out to be 5.76. So I will again take the first row, which is 25, 5, 1. This is the first row of my original A matrix. I'm going to multiply it by 5.76. And the reason why I'm multiplying 5.76 is because I want to get 144 here. So I'll get 144, 28.8, 5.76. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to subtract this multiple of row 1 from row 3. So my row 3 is 144, 12, and 1. That's my row 3. And I'm going to subtract this one from there, which is 144, 28.8, 5.76, and when I subtract it, I get 0, minus 16.8, minus 4.76. So that's my new row 3. That's my new row 3. So this has been again obtained by simply taking a multiple of one row and subtracting it from another row. So what that means is the determinant has not changed. So the determinant of my original matrix, which was 25, 5, 1, 64, 8, 1, 144, 12, 1, will be same as the determinant of the change matrix, which is 25, 5, 1, then I have a 0 here, and then I have minus 4.8 here, minus 1.56 here, and a 0 again here, minus 16.8 here, and minus 4.76. Now, I've not yet achieved the upper triangular matrix which I want to convert this coefficient matrix to, because I have to do the second step of elimination. Because if you have three rows and three columns, you have to conduct 3 minus 1 steps of elimination. So if somebody gives you 10 by 10 matrix to find the determinant of by using the forward elimination steps, you'll have to conduct 9 steps. That's how it's going to work. So in the second step of formulation, what I'm going to do is I want to make this to be 0. So in order to make this 0, I'll use my second row in my second step, second row, second column in my second step, to make this to be 0. So I'll have to divide this second row by minus 4.8 and multiply it by minus 16.8, which means same as multiplying by minus 16.8 divided by minus 4.8, which turns out to be 3.5. So I'm going to take my second row right here, which is this one, which is 0, minus 4.8, and minus 1.56, and I'm going to multiply it by 3.5. And when I multiply by 3.5, I get 0, minus 16.8, minus 5.46. That's what I get there. Now I can take this particular row here, which is the multiple of the second row, and subtract it from my third row of my this matrix here. So I'll take 0, minus 16.8, minus 4.76. This is my row 3. And then I'm going to subtract this 0, minus 16.8, minus 5.46. I'll end up with 0, 0, and 0.7. So that'll become my new row 3 now. So that'll become my new row 3. So since that becomes my new row 3, I will now be able to say that, hey, the determinant of the original matrix, which was 25, 5, 1, 64, 8, 1, 144, 12, 1, is same as the determinant of what happened at the end of the first step of formulation, which was 25, 5, 1, 0, minus 4.8, minus 1.56, 0, minus 16.8, minus 4.76. And then it'll be equal to the determinant of the matrix which I get at the end of the second step of formulation, which will be the last step, because I have only three rows, three columns. So 0, minus 4.8, and minus 1.56, 0, 0, 0.7. So since the three determinants are the same, but I know how to calculate the determinant of an upper triangular matrix, because it was simply the multiple of the diagonal elements. So that will be simply 25 times minus 4.8 times 0. This is supposed to be 0.7, and that gives you minus 84. So that's what I get as the determinant of the matrix there. And that's the end of this segment.